Watch and subscribe to the Message of the Hour with Apostle Simon Geshinga on YouTube channel as Watchman Peter LTV official channel. Watch and follow the deep revelations of the last days church and the wisdom teachings that prepare the bride of Christ for the marriage feast of the Lamb of God in complete holiness and righteousness. The end time trumpet voice preparing the church for the kingdom of God is near. Beyond, the Messiah is coming soon.
Amen. Hallelujah. So now I want us to start in Jesus' name, and I want us to pray in Jesus' name. Let us pray so that we may begin. Mighty Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we come before you, we glorify your holy name, and we praise you, for there is none like you in heaven and earth. Thank you, Father, for this revival message. Thank you, Father, for this message of the hour. Thank you for the revelation that you have given to us, that we may know the things of the kingdom of God. Mighty God, now your people are gathered. Lord, you say that wherever there are three or two that are gathered because of your name, you say that you are right there where they are. I now declare, Lord, through the grace of God, through your power, through your presence, may your presence be upon this place in Jesus' name. May you speak to men. May you speak to women. May you speak to your children in the name of Jesus for your own glory. Lord Jesus, I cover this revival. I cover this message, live transmission by the blood of Jesus. I pray, Father, every spirit of destruction, every spirit of cutting off, let it be rebuked in Jesus' name. Lord, preserve it for your own glory. Jehovah God, we welcome your presence, and I pray that you may open our understanding, our mind, our heart to give us the word of God, and let your name be glorified even afterward. In the name of Jesus, we do pray and even believe. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you, all of you, in Jesus' name. Yes, let us now read the word of God. Yes, I want us to read the word of God. I want us to read the word of God. Being the title, it is about launching out into the deep. The title of the message is called Launching Out into the Deep, or it is now the message itself when we say going deeper, going to the depth, going deeper. So the title, it is Launching Out into the Depth. So let us read in the book of Luke 5, we can start there, verses 3, or we can start there, verses 1. Let us start verses 1. We are reading Luke 5, and we want to read verses 1 to 4. That is where our message is coming from. And this is what the word of God is saying, and I am reading. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of the Gennesaret, and saw two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them, and were washing their net. And he entered into one of the ship, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now for, the Bible says, now when he had left speaking, he said to Simon, launch out into the deep, launch out into the deep, underline that, and let down your net for a draught. You see? And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let it down. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fish, and their nets broke. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless his word in Jesus' name. Now, this is when the disciples of Jesus Christ, when they, and like the disciple was called Simon, they were fishing. And here they are complaining that all night that they tried to fish, but there is nothing that they had. There is nothing that they got. All the night they tried to fish, but there's nothing that they had caught. And now when Jesus Christ came, he said to them, now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your net for a draught. You see, he was told, launch out into the deep. Launch out into the deep and let your net go deeper. Let your net go deeper.
This is the same message that Jesus Christ is speaking to Christian. He's speaking to every Christian, every child of God, that launch out into the deep. Launch out to the deep. Go beyond to the shallow. Go beyond that point. Go beyond that level. Go beyond your faith. Go beyond your salvation. Go beyond your life. Go launch out to the deep. That is when you will see what God is speaking about your life. Because right now, we have a form of Christianity that are very comfortable with the level that they are. That are like this Simon, that they were fishing, but they are not going to the deep. They are just fishing at the shallow. At the shallow. And you know, when you fish at the shallow, you cannot catch anything. And if you try to catch, you will catch the little fishes. Because the big fish or the greatest fish, like a whale and others, they are found in the deep, in the deeper place. So Jesus is telling the Christian, he is telling the church of Jesus right now, that now launch out into the deep, launch out in the deep. Stop operating in a level or in a shallow level. Stop operating in a shallow level. Now begin to launch your net, begin to launch into the deep and let your net go deeper. Let your net go deeper. Go beyond the Christianity. Go beyond your faith. Go beyond the place that you are. Many Christians right now, they are in a point of they are not growing. They are in a point of they are not moving. They are in a point of there is no power in them. They are in a point like of this Simon, that he is now just doing everything. He is now just fishing, but there is nothing. There is nothing. There is no showing up of anything. There is no fruit. Why? Because they have not let their net go deeper. They have not launched out into the deep. Jesus told Simon, go launch out into the deep. And when they obeyed that word, when they launched out to the deep, that is where they caught many fish that even their net broke. So you will have a rod that even the net will broke. Your cup will overfull. You see, because you have launched into the deep, you have gone beyond that point, beyond that level. Now many people are living in a type of Christianity that they are not moving, they are not growing, they are in that level of shallowness that you don't have the presence of God, that level of shallowness that people are operating, that kind of shallowness. You cannot feel the presence of God. You cannot even grow. You cannot enter into the depth. You cannot serve God in that condition, in that type of level. You need to go deeper. You need to go deeper. Because when you operate in that type of shallowness, there are things that you cannot catch. There are things that you cannot understand. There are things that you cannot possess. There are things that you cannot receive. There are things that you cannot get. If you operate in a shallow level, if you operate in a shallow level, the level of the anointing, the level of your grace, the level of your faith, the level of your standard, the level of your Christianity, you cannot receive some of the things. You cannot even walk with God, because your problem is the level that you are operating on. Your problem is the level, is that ground. You are too shallow. You need to go deeper. Go deeper. That is what Jesus Christ told Simon, that go deeper, launch out to the deep, launch out your net to the deep. And that is where you catch your blessings. That is where you catch the great fish or the many fishes, you see. And that is like a fisherman. Those who are fishermen, they know that when they go deeper, it is when they go deeper, they catch the greater fish. But if they don't go the deeper, they cannot catch anything. You know, even those which we call frog, they operate in the shallow places, The scorpion, they operate in the shallow places. So you may be fishing, you may be operating in that level of frog, the level of scorpion. You need to go deeper so that you may catch a fish, so that you may now receive that presence. You see, that is also like that revelation of Ezekiel, how he was shown somebody who was with the measurement. And he was told by the Spirit of God, now go to the river. He was told to go to the river and he would measure. And there is a water that he measured, the water, and it was in the tall level, the level of the toes. And there is another level, the level of the knee. There is another level, the level of waist. There is another level, the level of the neck. He was told to measure because it is like somebody who is entering through the river. When you enter into the river, you find that there is levels, the toe levels, the knee levels, you see the waist level, the neck level, and then the flowing river, the flowing level that now you have now fully immersed. We need to go deeper. We need to go deeper. I don't know why many people, they love to operate in the shallow places. That you hear Christian, they say, oh, you know, me, I don't want to go deeper. Me, I am just a Christian. I don't want to go deeper. When you try to tell him we must go deeper, he say, no, me, I don't go deeper. I do not. I just want to be there. And they are using a word called, I don't want to be overrighteous. I am speaking not overrighteous. I am speaking about going deeper. When you tell people you need to go deeper, they say they want to stay there in a shallow level. That in a level where they are not growing, they are not increasing, they are not stable, in a level where they are just struggling. No, we need to enter in this level of the depth, because in the depth, that is where there is the blessing. In the depth, that is where there is the presence of the Lord. In the depth of the thing, that is where you will experience the presence of the Lord. That is where you will experience the glory of God. That is where you will experience the treasures of the Lord. That is where you will experience the power of the Lord. You see, unless you go deeper, you cannot experience God. So, many people asking, oh, why am I not growing? You need to go deeper. There are people who go to church, but the churches that they go, it is a shallow church. A shallow church, a message that is very shallow. A message that does not touch it. A message that does not bring people to repentance. A message that does not change people, transform people. What are you doing in such churches? What are you doing in such fellowship, such gathering? Shallow messages, you cannot experience the presence of God. You know, when you go to those places, when you operate in that shallow places, you cannot mature. You cannot find out the glory of God. You cannot experience His manifestation. You cannot experience the growth in your life because you are operating in a shallow place. We need to go deeper. I hear the Spirit of God saying, the church, we need to go deeper. The bride of Jesus, we need to go deeper in order to know what is there in the depth. There is a lot of the things that are in the depth, but many people, they just look things there at the shallow. It is like when you see an island. When you look at an island, when you are at afar, you just see an island, just a rock there above the water. But when you go depth, you will see that there is a great zone. It extends so much. So it is like that way. Many people are just operating in a shallow place and they don't want to go deeper. We need to go deeper. Unless you go deeper, you cannot know what you are dealing with. Unless you go deeper, you cannot know even who is God. Unless you go deeper, you cannot experience the greatness of this message. You cannot experience the greatness of our God. We need to know the depth of our God. We need to know the depth of salvation. Let us not be shallow Christian, that you are just a Christian and it is over with you. You don't want to continue. You don't want to go to dig out to know more about Christianity. People, many Christians, they have reached to that point of like there is no more another level. That when you just receive Jesus, you are just a Christian. That is over. That they do not go beyond Christianity. Just going to church, it is over. Just reading the Bible, it is over. Just listen, it is not over. It is over. No, we need to go deeper. We need to go deeper more than going to the church. Go deeper more than reading the Word of God. Go deeper more than pray. Go deeper until you see the depth of the Lord. Hallelujah. You see, even in the churches, most of the churches, they are preaching, but they are not preaching the deeper message. They are preaching that shallow. And you will hear the preacher saying, oh, you stop sinning. But you not go deeper and tell people, what are those sinning? You know, a preacher that go deeper, he will say, when you say stop sinning, he will go deeper. Which sin am I speaking? speaking about. I'm speaking about immorality. I'm speaking about pornography. I'm speaking about nakedness. I'm speaking about this and this. Go into detail. Go into detail. Unless you go deeper, you cannot understand the message. Unless you go deeper, you cannot even grow. You cannot experience the presence of the Almighty God. You cannot experience the end time glory that God is saying that He will bring to His people, the Church of Jesus Christ. Let us go deeper. Don't become familiar with that level that you are, that you want now to become familiar, that now is like you have found rest. You have found rest in that level, that now you are a Christian, now it is over. In that level, now you have found rest. You are now comfortable with that level. I am not comfortable in this level that I am. I want to go deeper. I want to know God deeper. I want to know him deeper. I want to go deeper in his word, deeper in his presence, deeper in the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because there are things that we cannot experience in this level. There are things that we cannot experience in this shallow level unless we go deeper. We cannot experience the presence of the Lord. We cannot experience the power of the Almighty God. You see, there are things that we call treasures. Treasures. Who know who? What is treasures? Treasures. Treasures. Treasures are precious. Treasures are precious gift. And treasures are stored in the depth. They are stored in the deep. Treasures are not just found in their shadow. In their shadow. When those people who go to dig the treasures, treasures are things like silver, things like gold. When they go to dig out the treasures, those gold, they don't just collect gold at the shallow or at the higher ground. No, they don't just collect the gold there above. They need to go deeper. They go beyond the stone, they go beyond the rock, they go beyond the soil, they go beyond the layer to layer. And when they go beyond it, when they dig deeper, that is when they receive the gold. That is where they receive some of the treasures. So if that is what it is with gold, and gold is just a physical, how much the things of spiritual? There are things you cannot just correct like that, in that level of shallowness, in that level that you are, that you say, oh, I will receive them. You will never receive them. Because those things require for Christian, require for you and me to go deeper, to find that those things, to seek those things, so that you may reveal, God may reveal to you, so that you may receive from God. Hallelujah. There are certain things that you cannot receive in that level. You must go deeper. Launch out the deep. Launch out to the deep. Launch out your net to the deep, so that you may understand some of the things. You may be just fighting with the people, but when you go deeper, you will not fight with the people, because your eyes shall be open. You may be just saying, oh, I don't believe it. But when you go deeper into the word, deeper into prayer, deeper into fasting, deeper into searching and seeking God, that's when God will reveal you deep things that you don't know. The word of God says in the book of Jeremiah that seek the Lord with all your heart. Seek the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind. Meaning seek the Lord so deep and go beyond with all your mind, with all your heart. And He will reveal you things that you have never known. Things that the ears have never heard. Things that the eyes have never seen. Those are the things that are kept, are stored in the depth. There is a lot of the things that God has kept for us in the depth of His Spirit, in the depth of His message, in the depth of walking with God. There is a lot that we need to hear. There is a lot that we need to dig out. There is a lot that we need to seek from God. So that we may receive them, you must go deeper. You must go deeper to the presence of the Lord. You must find them. You must look for them. You must be eagerly seeking for God. You must do something. Don't be comfortable with that level that you are. Because like gold is not being found just in this presence. Gold is found by those who are very serious. Those who determine to go deeper. To dig deeper. And that is why you see that God, being the creator of heaven and earth, He created things that are upper and things that are deep. And those things that just are up here, they are not precious. They are not precious. When you look at the layer of the soil that is just upper is not precious. But when you go deeper, the things that are in deeper, Those things are very precious. Some of them, they are gold. Some of them, they are precious stones. So you see, God had to put best thing under. Best thing are found under. They are found deeper. They are found depth at the bottom. They are found there at the bottom. That is where they are found. Things that are best, things that are glorious. The presence of God is found by those that goes to the depth. Hallelujah. Those that go to the depth. Look at the potato. The potato, when you want a good potato, it is, you must dig the depth. You must dig at the depth. And that is potato. Even the sweet potato, they do not just grow above the soil in the shallow places. A good potato and the largest potato and the cassava and those yam, they are things that you have to dig them at the depth. There are things that you must dig them. You must enter to the depth to dig those things out. So if that is so with the potato, that the potato is, you must go dig it to the depth so that you may receive that sweet potato, that cassava, that yam. What about the things of the spiritual? You cannot just receive them there in the ground. There in the ground. You must go deeper to the ground. You must go deeper that level. You must seek those things. That means you must go beyond that place. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Unless you go deeper, you cannot experience, you cannot be given those treasures of the Almighty God. Of the Almighty God. Why? There are things that unless we go deeper, we cannot experience. The reason why you see that the people are being carried out, it is because they are not going deeper. Let me tell you another secret of going deeper. Look at this. Those boats and those things that are above the water, when there is a wind, when there is a storm, those who are operating in that shallow places, when the storm comes, those people will be shaken by the storm. Boats, even if there is those what we call fish, they will be shaken by the storm because they are very shallow. They are there, they are at the ground, or they are there at the ground, that level. That is so. But those things that are under, they are very deeper. They are at the depth. When the storm comes, they cannot feel even the storm. They cannot feel the shaking. That is how it is with the church. That if you are a Christian, if you go to the depth of the Christianity, the depth of your faith, if you go deeper in the Holy Spirit, if you go deeper in righteousness, if you go deeper in holiness, you cannot experience some of the storm. Because those storms, they cannot penetrate in the depth. They cannot penetrate in the depth. In the depth, they will be hiding there. It is also like a tree. There is two trees. One tree is planted and its roots have not gone into the depth. And another tree is planted, but its roots have gone down into the depth of the depths of the soil. When the storm comes, tell me which tree will be left standing. Which tree will not be shaken? And if it will be shaken, it will still stand. And which tree will be shaken and will be uprooted? It is that tree that has not gone into the depth. Into the depth. That tree that its roots have not gone into the depth will be shaken when the storm comes. That is so with a Christian. That is so with the Christians. That is so with the people. That if you will not go down to the root, if your root will not go to the deeper, if your righteousness will not be deeper, if your holiness will not go deeper, if your fasting, if your prayers will not go deeper, I tell you that when the time of shaking, you will be shaken because your root just go above. At the surface, your root are just at the surface. But if your root go deeper into the depth, I tell you, you will stand in the days. You will stand in the evil days. You will not be shaken. You will not be moved. You will not be uprooted by the storm. You will not be uprooted by the wind. You see, because you have roots. You have roots. And those roots, they have gone to the deeper. They have gone deeper. So that is how you are able to survive. My dear brother and my sister, it is also another example that I want to give you about the truth, those two trees. If that tree, its roots have gone through and it have touched the water. The water is found at the depth. Now, those trees that their roots go deeper. Those trees, when they go deeper, they touches the water, they consume the water, because the water is not just found at the surface. The water soil or the water places, that water is found in the depth. So when the time of dry season comes, that water will still stand. It will be still be green. That water will be still bear fruit. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. That water will still bear fruit. It will still produce fruit. It will still give forth the fruit. That tree. Why? Because its roots have touched to the course of the water. But that tree, that its root is just surface. It has not gone deeper. I tell you, when the dry season comes, that tree will not give fruit. That tree will get dry. Will wither. And that is how most of people are doing. Most of Christians, they are withering. They are getting dry. They are withering. Why? Because they do not have roots. Their roots have not gone deeper. You need to go deeper, my sister. You need to go deeper, my brother. Let your root go deeper into Christianity. Not just dressing. Not just going to the church. Not just tithing. Not just offering. You need to go deeper. Your root need to go deeper to holiness. Deeper to righteousness. Deeper to prayer. Deeper to fasting. You need to go deeper to the word of God. Hallelujah. So that you may remain standing in this end time, my dear brother and my sister. Unless we go deeper, there are things that we cannot experience. There are things that we never see. There are treasures that you will never touch with your own hand. Because you have not gone deeper. Why do we see that when two people who are farmers, when they dig out, one do not receive and the other receive? Because the one who receive is the one that dig out the ground, is the one that go deeper. When those two people who are digging out for gold, they are called miners. When they go digging out, if they don't go deeper, if they don't go at the depth, they cannot receive any gold. They cannot dig out any treasure, my dear brother, my sister. Is that the reason why you have not been receiving the treasures of the Lord? Is that the reason why you have not been growing? Is that the reason why you are not bearing fruit? Because your level that you are operating is a shallow level. You need to go deeper. Go deeper. Yes, go deeper into righteousness. Stop with that righteousness. You know, right now people have just stayed in that righteousness that, oh, I'm going to church. Oh, I'm tithing. Oh, I'm dressing well. Oh, I'm not even using makeup. Oh, it is about the dressing. Go deeper that dressing. Go deeper that outward appearance. Those things, we call them outward appearance. But we know we need to go deeper in the inward appearance. That is when we shall discover the things that are maybe even giving us headache, things that are our problem. That is how when we shall overcome some of the spiritual battle, when we go deeper. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God requires his people to go deeper. Let us read this in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us read this in the book of 1 Corinthians. In the book of 1 Corinthians, you will see that God deserves us to go deeper. God wants us to go deeper. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. First Corinthians. Let us go deeper to the word of God. 1 Corinthians 2:10. This is what the word of God says. 2:10, the Bible says this. But God has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all the things. Yeah, the deep things of God. Hallelujah. You see, that for God has revealed them unto us by his spirit. For the spirit searches all the things, yeah, the deep things of God. Hallelujah. So powerful that there are things that are being revealed by the Holy Spirit. When we go deeper, when we go deeper to the things of God, God reveals them through the Holy Spirit. Because yeah, the deep things of God. So meaning there are things that God will reveal to us by his Holy Spirit. How can you receive it if you are not flowing with God? How can you receive it if you are just flowing? How can you receive such things? So you need to go deeper. Launch out into the deep, into the depth of the prayer, into the depth of righteousness, into the depth of obedience. Becoming obedience. Go deeper in becoming obedience. People are still struggling with obedience. You are not obedience. Here and here, you're not. Go deeper into obedience. If it is righteousness, go deeper into righteousness. If becoming faithfulness, go deeper in becoming faithfulness. Until you go deeper, you cannot experience those things. The Holy Spirit cannot explain to you. He cannot give those things to you. There are things that God cannot reveal to the baby Christian. He cannot reveal to the baby Christian. He requires us to mature. He requires us to mature, to go deeper, to go deeper, to mature, to grow, to go deeper with him, to go beyond with him, so that we may be revealed such things. You see, it is like a child. Even if you are a child of a king, The king cannot reveal you his treasures because you are too young. You are too young to understand. You are too young for those things. So the king will be patient with you until the time that you will be now a man of understanding. When you will grow up, that is when the king will take you and he will start showing you his treasures. Because treasures are only trusted to those people that are matured. Treasured and sacred, they are preserved for those that are matured, them that know how to go deep, how to seek the Lord. That's why the Bible says that blessed are those who seek and hunger for righteousness, for they shall be filled. How can you be blessed and how can you be revealed the sacred things, the treasures, things of God, when you are not hungering for the word of God, when you don't thirst for the word of God, when you are like you have become so familiar with the word of God, you have become like you are tired with the word of God, you are tired with the righteousness, you don't seek righteousness. Those that will be revealed, those deep secret of the kingdom of God, the depth of God, by the Holy Spirit, there are people who seek and thirst for righteousness. They thirst for the kingdom of God. They want to enter. Only they that will be revealed those things that God is speaking about them. Let us read also in the book of Romans 11:33. In the book of 11:33, let us read Romans 11:33. Romans 11:33, so that we may go deeper. We may go deeper. Above that place, go deeper beyond that place that you are. Go deeper. Don't be comfortable. Don't say that now I have reached. Don't say now I have reached. You know, there are people who say, now I have reached where I was going. Now this is the place that I was going. No, don't reach that place. We are still pilgrim. We are still moving. There are things that we need to run. We need to go deeper. Deeper more than that place that you are. So that some of the things, God will reveal them unto you. Hallelujah. Yes, I am reading the book of Romans. Romans 11:33. This is what the word of God says in the book of Romans 11:33. And I am reading Romans 11:33. The Bible says this. Yes. It says that 3. The depth of the riches, both of wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgment and his ways past finding out. Look at that. He's saying the depth of the riches, both of wisdom and of knowledge. Look at that. That there is depth, the depth of the riches. You see, there are people who can say, I have received the riches. But you have not received the depth of the riches. There are people who can say, I have a wisdom. you have not still received. There is something that we call the depth of the wisdom, the depth of the knowledge of God. So the things that you think you know, if you want to run, become a baby so that you may continue to run. There are people that have received, have seen everything. They think that they have seen everything. They have met everyone. They have risen everything. But now they seem as if it is the end of that thing. There is no end of knowledge. There is no end of wisdom. There is things that we call the depth of the riches, both of wisdom and of knowledge of God. There is the depth of the wisdom. There is the depth of the knowledge of God. So when you seek God, when you don't become comfortable with that level, you keep on seeking God. You keep on going deeper to that place you are. The place you are, go deeper to that place. Yes, you need to know God more. You need to know His judgment. You need to know His holiness. The Bible says, how unsearchable are His judgment and His way past them finding out. You see that how they say, and how unsearchable are His judgment and His ways past finding out. That when you find those things, you will see that how much God is great because you have known Him. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. You see, if you don't go deeper, you cannot know your God. You can just say, oh God, my God, my God, why this, why this, why this? You can just be complaining. You know, in the level of the shallow level, people are very complaining. In the shallow level, people complain a lot because they don't know what is there. They don't know what is there, what is at the bottom. They don't know what is at the depth. You see, when God calls you, He just shows you something that is at the surface. If it is your ministry, you just see that ministry in the surface. In the surface. So in the surface, you all see it is complaining. You all see it is battle. You all see it is just hard time and trials and testing. That is what you see at the surface. But if you can go deeper into what God has given you, deeper into who you are, if you can go to the depth of God, I tell you, you can rejoice, my brother. You can rejoice, my sister. You can give glory to the Lord. You will never complain. If you go to the depth, you will see why those things are happening. It is like somebody complaining, oh God, why this, why this, why this? But when you go deeper into that thing, I tell you cannot complain again, because you will see what God has reserved for they that wait upon Him. You will see those things, those treasures, those gifts, those presents, those blessings that God have reserved for you. If you overcome that level and go deeper, that's when you shall start enjoying the work of God. There are people that even do not enjoy prayers. There are people who don't enjoy even the preachings. There are people who don't enjoy the reading of the Word of God. There are people who don't enjoy Christianity. Why? Because you are in that shallow level of complaining. Oh God, this is why are you God? You see, because you are there in the place of shadow. But when you can go deeper, you will never even complain, because you know, oh God, why this is happening? Because you have a good purpose over my life. Oh God, thank you, because what your word say, that whatever that happened, it happened for good for those that are called according to the will of God. So when you go to the deeper, you will understand the meaning of your life. You will understand who you are. You will understand the things that you are passing through. You will understand why the things that are coming, and why are they speaking that way? Why are things turning out to be that? You will understand if you go to the depth. Hallelujah, praise Jesus Christ. You will understand them. You will understand them. The problem you will understand when you go to the depth. It is like that what we call there's a rat. There is a kind of a rat that goes underground. A kind of a rat that goes underground. I don't know how we call it. We call it moor. It is a type of rodent or a type of a rat that goes that it digs the hole, then it goes at the surface of the soil. And the farmers, they have problem with that rat, because that rat goes at the surface at that depth, and then it start cutting the root, cutting and eating the root of the maize. Cutting and eating the root of the plants, the plant or the tree. And when the farmer comes to look the fruit or the tree, he see this tree is not progressing. This tree is not bearing fruit. This tree is withering. Why is this tree becoming dry? Why is this tree dying? And when the farmer go deeper at the root, when he go deeper, that is when he see, oh, the tree, the roots are cut. The roots are spoiled. The roots are cut. The roots are spoiled by this rat. So this rat has polluted, has destroyed, have eaten the root. So that's why the tree is withering. So you see, some of the things, some of the problem, we cannot know them unless we go to the depth. Some people are battling even in some spiritual battle. Some people are battling with the things in the life, in the family. But you cannot know what is happening. You cannot find the solution if you don't go the depth of the root. That is when you see what is happening with the root, what is happening in the ground. Things are different in the ground. Things are different there at the depth. So we need to go deeper so that we may understand some of the things that are happening in our life, in our family. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us not become comfortable with that level. Let us not become comfortable. Let us launch out into the depth so that we may begin to receive the treasures of the Lord, so that we may begin to receive those which are called fish, the great fish. Or the greater fish, they are in the depth. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the word of God is saying, oh, the depth of the riches, both of wisdom and of knowledge of God. There are things that we call the depth of the riches, both of knowledge and of the riches of God. Hallelujah. There is the depth of the wisdom of God, that when you can be revealed some of his wisdom, some of his knowledge, some of his message, when God can just reveal to you and teach you those things, I tell you, your life can be changed. Your life can be changed, because the way you see things, you cannot see them again. The way you see things outward, you cannot see those things inward. We need to go deeper. We need to go deeper so that we may experience that presence of the Almighty God. So that unless you go deeper, you cannot experience those things. Your eyes cannot be open. You can just look in things as if it is normal. But those people who go deeper, they don't look all things as if they are normal. They know that things at the ground, they are different. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we need to go deeper. Not just going to the church. Let us go deeper. Let us mature up. Have your time with the word of God. Have your time with the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't just remain in that level. Go deeper. Go deeper the level. Go beyond the level of going to the church. Read the Bible for yourself. Huh? Seek the Lord for yourself. Don't just be comfortable in that level. Go beyond the level of going to the church. Go beyond the level of tithing. Go beyond the level of offering the offering. There are people who, oh God, I offer the offering. Oh, I tithe. Oh, I go to church. What is happening? Go deeper. Go deeper offering. Go deeper going to the church. Go deeper tithing. Go deeper and you understand what is happening in your life. There are things that you cannot be revealed by just going to the church. There are things that God cannot just reveal you by just tithing, by just offering. There are things that you cannot receive them by just doing so. Those things that the Christian do, those things are good to do. But those things are not the end of that praise. You need to go deeper. It is very shallow. That is very shallow. We need to go deeper so that we may receive what God has spoken over our life. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. Did you go deeper and you see the life of prophets, the life of the apostles, and you see the life of the children of God? They were people who were going deeper with the Lord. They were not just going at the shallow. They were not just going at the shallow. They were going deeper. You see, that is what we need to go deeper. Even about the Christianity nowadays, this is for Christianity of holiness, the holiness peoples, the holiness Christian that now are coming. You see, those people, they are just going just on outward appearance. Go deeper the dressing. Go deeper the dressing. Some people are like devils inside. But when you go deeper the dressing, that is when you receive the devil. There are people that know how to dress well. outward appearance, they are like angels. How they dress well, how they cover themselves, they don't use makeup. They even they cover the head. So when you look at them, you see as if they are angels. But when you go deeper to them, you find that they are just devils. They are just like agents of darkness. You find that they have a lot of problem. They have a lot of wickedness, a lot of madness that they are doing. So let us go deeper our dressing. You ladies, you women, you men, let us go beyond the outward appearance. Everybody is preaching the outward appearance. It is good for shallow believers, for shallow Christians that have just received God, that just want to be transformed. But after being transformed outward, you need to go deeper in the inward transformation. Hallelujah. In the inward transformation. Unless you go deeper, you cannot even stand. There are people who are struggling, but they because they have just they just have that outward appearance and that outward level of now I am transformed. It is, if it is dressing, I am dressing now well. So what is the problem? Go deeper, my dear brother. Go deeper. Let us not just act like this. You see, there are people that were called the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And if we don't watch out, most of people nowadays, most of Christians of righteousness, of holiness, they are now becoming like the Pharisees. Why? They are dressing long robes. They are dressing well. The outward appearance, it is good. Outward appearance, it is good. It is fine. But when you go deeper in those people, they are still living in sin. They are still in sexual sin. They are still in lusting. They are still in bitterness. They are still in bitterness, in unforgiveness. They are still in pride. There are things that they are still doing. They are not matured. You find that they are just having a form of outward appearance. But when you go deeper in their second life, in their inner life, you find that their heart is very dirty. Hallelujah. Their heart is very dirty. There are people who say, oh, why God is this happening to me? That you find that you are dressing outward appearance, physically, you dress well. It is good. You don't use makeup. You don't use all those things. But when you sleep in at the dream, you see yourself naked. But physically, you are covered. So what is the meaning of that? Go deeper that place. Don't think because you are covered, you are dressing well. Go deeper and know why did you show yourself you are naked. There is something that God is revealing you. Go deeper and you know yourself. You may be physically covered, but spiritually you are naked. You may be physically covered. Physically, the outward appearance, it looks nice, but the inward appearance, it is decaying. The outward man that we see, it is good. He looks like he's alive. But when you look at the inner man, he's dying. He's struggling. When you look at the outward appearance, the man is well. The man is alive. But when you go deeper and look at the inner man, he's dying. He's no more there. He's decaying. He's a skeleton. Let us go deeper so that you may understand. You may begin to understand why we need to go deeper in holiness. Why we need to go deeper in dressing up. Why we need to go deeper and beyond the dressing, beyond the outward appearance, beyond going to church, beyond just tithing, beyond just offering, beyond just we need to go deeper so that we may prepare for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There are people that are still struggling. They say, oh, why am I still struggling? And I have transformed myself. Why? And I'm not doing this and this. Why? And I have changed my outward appearance. Why am I still experiencing some of the things? You need to go deeper. Go deeper in your heart and you will see why those things are coming out. Because in the heart, in the depth of the heart, that is where the evil dwells. That is where the devil dwells at the deeper. When you go deeper, that is when you see all the problems that you have been fighting on, all those dreams that you have been fighting on, all those trials, all those things that you keep on doing. You keep on sinning and you are in holiness and you are a Christian. Why? Go to the depth. And you know the root of those sin, the root of those evil mind, the root of all those dreams, the root of what you are passing through. Hallelujah. Let us go deeper. Let us go deeper, deeper spiritually, so that we may begin to understand those things. The word of God says in the book of Matthew, I don't know if the Matthew what, it says that out of the heart come out all evil things. Out of the heart, out of heart, the Bible says, out of heart come out all evil things. It come out of the heart, that is where lying come from, that is where nakedness come from, you see. Out of the heart, that is where sexual immorality comes from. Out of the heart, that is where the evil speaking, the lying, the insult, they come there. So everything that is evil, it comes out in the heart. So when you just look people outward, you cannot know, you cannot see what is the problem. But when you go deeper in the heart, that is when you see that there is evil, there is greater the devil that is living in the inner. In the inner, because what we see in the shadow, it is just that. But when you go to the depth, that is when you see that we are not ready. Praise Jesus Christ. Unless you go deeper, you cannot know if you are ready for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. You may be saying, oh, I'm ready for the coming of Jesus. Because when you look at the shadow Christianity, about now, about outward appearance, I'm dressing well, I'm not using makeup, I'm not using those trousers, I'm not shaving like this. You see, I'm now dressing well because I have that outward appearance. That one, you are not ready. You are not still ready for the coming of Jesus. You need to go deeper, that outward appearance. You know, you need to go deeper into holiness. You need to go deeper into righteousness. You need to go deeper into the secrets and the wisdom of the Lord Jesus Christ, so that you may become matured, so that you may know the will of God upon your life. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is why out of the heart, it comes out all evil mind, all immoral thought, all stealing, all robbery, all murder. They begin in the heart. Those things begin in the heart. You know, when people start sinning, they don't just start sinning by just things outward, by the shadow. When you start sinning, you start sinning in your heart. Those people who enter into sexual immorality, they start committing sexual immorality in their heart. Go deeper. Go at the depth of your heart. That is when you know some of the things where they start from. The factory of the evil, where sin is being formed, it is in the heart. You see, where sin is being fashioned, it is in the heart. That is where sin, wickedness, lying, nakedness. You see, this immorality, this is how people are dressing. It is not about the outward. Where you see people dressing outside there, dressing immoral dressing, nakedness, it all starts in the heart. Because the factory of wickedness is fashioned in the heart. In the heart, that is where they think about immorality. That is where they think about stealing. That is where they think about lying. That is where they think about doing something evil. So the factory of the wickedness is in the heart. So if you can go deeper in the heart, you can overcome sin. But you not overcome sin in the shadow places, in the service. Oh, I'm trying to overcome sin. But when I see sin, I go this way. No, you cannot overcome like that. You need to go deeper. Go deeper. Rouch out in the deep. Go deeper. Go deep. Go into the depth. And you will see where sin are being functioned. Where sin are being fashioned. In where their origin is there. Where there is the root. Go and start uprooting. Uprooting those root, the root in your life, the root that has been stumbling you, the root that has been hindering you from experiencing the presence. You need to root them at the root. Uproot them at the root. Don't just be comfortable at that level of the shallowness. There are things that you cannot overcome. There are certain battle that you cannot overcome. There are certain sin that you cannot overcome when you operate in these shallow places. Shallow places. You see, it is like somebody who want to fry. You want to fry, you want to fry, but you are still gathering and walking with the chicken. Have you ever seen a chicken frying above the sky? Have you ever seen chicken frying above the sky? You have never seen. So if you want to fry, you need to walk with the eagles. Walk with those that are walking and frying. That is a level. So it is like saying you are in the shallow place and you are gathering with the people that are in the shallow place. So how shall you go into the depth if you are walking and operating and walking with the people that are in the shadow? Unless you walk with the people that are going into the depth, you cannot discover those things that are hidden in the depth. You cannot fry. So stop walking with a chicken if you are an eagle. Walk with the eagles. Walk with those that are going above. Walk with those. Fellowship with those that are frying. Don't walk with the chicken. The chicken, they just scratch at the surface. They just scratch at the surface. But the eagle cannot scratch at the surface. The eagle flies above. You see? That is how it is. Even, it is like the battles. Some of the battles, you cannot fight them and overcome them at the shadow. You need to fly above. You need to go at the depth. That is when you will overcome those battles. You will uproot them. You will uproot those battles. You will uproot them. Why? Because you have found the sacred. You have found that thing. My dear brother and my sister, you need to know the truth. And when you need the truth, when you know the truth shall come to set you free. Why are we operating in places that there is no presence? Why are we operating in the presence that there is no presence of God? It is because you are operating in a shallow place. It is because you are operating in a place that is not deep. You need to go deeper. You need to go deeper so that you can see the things that you have never seen with your eyes. So that you can hear the things that you have never heard with your ears. You see, those people that are called marine people, they are people who are called marine researchers. They are people who are swimmers. They are swimmers or divers. Divers. Those divers, unless when they go deeper, the more they go deeper, the more they see a world that they have never seen under the water. The more they dive deeper, the more they see fishes that they have never seen. Fishes that and species of sea of fish. Marine animals that have never been discovered. So when you go deeper with Christ, deeper in prayer, deeper in fasting, deeper in the word of God, deeper into the presence of God, deeper in righteousness, deeper in holiness, you will start to see things that many people have never seen. You will start to discover some of the things that have never been discovered. You will start operating in some of the level that people have never went through. Why? Because you have gone deeper. That is the soul concerning this, that unless you go to the deeper, you can never see some of the things. That's why you find there are people who say, oh, there is no heaven. Why? Because they are operating in a shallow place. In a shallow place, you don't see. You just see here. You don't see beyond the sky. You don't see beyond the sky. That's why they say, oh, there is no God. There is no heaven. Why? They operate in a shallow place. And in the shallow place, in the surface, you don't see beyond the sky. But when you go beyond the sky, you see there is another heaven. You see there are planets. You see there is universe. You see? So when you operate in those places, there are things that you can even deny. But when you operate in the depth, into the depth, when you go to the depth, I tell you, you will discover you yourself. You will know things you yourself. You will not be told. You will discover by yourself. And there is power when you are a witness of your own eyes. When you are a witness of your own ears. You heard it. I tell you, there is power. Yes, there is power because you go deeper. Because you have gone deeper. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. Look at this. Let us read in the book of Ephesians. Ephesians 3. Ephesians 3:18. Ephesians 3:18. Ephesians 3:18. Ephesians 3:18. This is what the word of God saying. It is saying this. Ephesians. We can start 3:16. Let us start 3:16. Ephesians 3:16. It starts by saying this. That he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with the might by his spirit in the inner man. 17 says this. That Christ may dwell in your heart by faith, that you may being rooted, but you being rooted and grounded in the love. You see, being rooted, meaning you have gone deep at the root and you have been grounded in the love. 18 say, may be able to comprehend with all the saints. You may be able to comprehend after you have gone at the root after you are grounded and you are rooted, you will be able to comprehend with the all said, what is the breadth, you look at what is the breadth, and what is the length, and what is the depth, and what is height, and to know the love of Christ which passes the knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. This is powerful. He's saying that after you have gone to the root, after you have gone deeper, after you have rounded out into the depth, that when you will be able to comprehend and you will be able to know the breadth, the length, the depth, and the height of God. Praise Jesus. The height, the depth, the breadth, and the length, the depth, the height of God. And you shall know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with all fullness. You see, that you shall able to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. That means there are things that we shall know. We shall know the height of God, the height of goodness. We shall know the height. We shall know the breadth. We shall know the height. We shall know the depth. We shall know everything when we go deeper, when we go deeper to the root. Praise Jesus Christ. Let us seek God. Let us seek God in that kind of a way, so that you may begin to see those things that God is speaking to us. That when you know, when you go deeper in those things, that's when you'll be able to see and to experience the presence of the Lord God Almighty. You will begin to be given knowledge. You will be given to be given the revelation. You will be given to be revealed the wisdom, the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ, because you have gone at the root. Hallelujah. Let us go deeper. Let us go deeper. When you read the word of God, go deeper. Don't just read a verse. Don't just read a verse. There are people who read the Bible by just reading a verse and it is over. Go deeper. Read the whole of the chapter. That is what we call going deeper. When you are just praying, don't just pray for you to finish. Go deeper. Pray until you feel that the presence of God is around you. Until you feel as if you are in heaven, but you are in the earth. Go deeper into whatever that you are doing. When you go deeper, you will experience that grace. You will experience those things that we have never had. You will experience and you will be able to see the height, the breadth, and also the depth of the knowledge of Jesus and what has been preserved for those that wait upon God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I tell you, unless we go deeper, there are things that we cannot overcome. There are battles that we cannot overcome. There are sins that we cannot overcome. Hallelujah. We need to go deeper. Go deeper the dreaming. Go deeper the dreaming. Oh, don't give up. I'm dreaming. Go deeper that dreaming. Go deeper and you know the depth of everything. The depth of the problem. The depth of the battle. Go deeper. And that's where you will have this victory about overcoming, because there are battles that you cannot win if you just operate in the shallow places. There are rivers that you cannot go if you operate that shallow places. Praise the name of the living God. Yes, you need to go deeper. When you go deeper, that is when you will receive some of the things. You will receive those things. There are rivers that you cannot receive those things. There are blessings that you cannot receive in that place. There are answers that you cannot receive in that shallow places. There are those treasures that you cannot receive in those shallow places. But when you go into the depth, when you go and rouge your net into the depth, I tell you, there are levels that you will begin to see. There are blessings that you will begin to see. There are answers that you will begin to hear from God. There are those treasures, gifts, glory that you begin to receive from God because you have gone deeper. Hallelujah. You have gone deeper. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We must go deeper to the word of God. We must go deeper righteousness. We must go deeper holiness. We must go deeper. Yes, go deeper. Go deeper. Go deeper outward appearance. Go deeper walking with the Lord. Go deeper walking with the Holy Spirit. Go deeper. And you will experience the presence of the Almighty God. You will stand when others are not standing. You will be standing because you have known the secret of going deeper to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, brother and sister. Let us go deeper. Don't just pray. Go deeper. If it is prayer, go deeper and begin fasting. Go deeper and begin fasting. Yes, until you experience though that level of the depth of God. In the depth of God, in the depth of God, that's when you will receive what you wanted. You see, I told you as I started that the good gift, the good things, they are not at the shadow. They are not at the shadow. Most of the people, the treasures, gold, precious stone, precious things, they are found at the depth. They are found under the ground, under the ground, beneath the ground there. They are found beneath, under the ground, under the rocks. People used to hide their treasures there. And those are the things. Even God hide his treasures. He hide his blessing in the depth. In the depth. There are people who are saying, oh God, oh Lord, I'm waiting for marriage partner. Oh, I'm waiting for a good marriage. How will you receive that marriage if you are just operating in the shallow places? You see, you cannot receive it. You cannot receive it. Change your level. Change your level. Start going deeper. You see, it is like somebody saying, oh, I'm waiting to catch a fish. I'm waiting to catch a fish. But you are just in that surface level of the water. You are just surface level of the water. You are there at the soil. So you are saying, I'm waiting to catch a fish. You will not catch a fish. You will catch a frog. Because in that surface level, there are a lot of the frog. So whatever you cut, you receive will be a frog. Oh God, I'm waiting a marriage partner. You will receive frog, and the frog will disturb you. But when you go deeper into holiness, go deeper into fasting, go deeper into righteousness, go deeper into the knowledge of Christ, go deeper into the presence of the Lord, go deeper into righteousness, that's when you receive the treasures that are found in the depth. The blessings, the answers that are found in the depth, you will receive a good partner, you will receive a good marriage, you will receive a good thing that you are asking. The thing that you are asking, go deeper. Hallelujah. Because things that are good, things that are precious, things that are worth, they are found at the depth, not at the shadow. Not at the shadow. Hallelujah. And the people do not want to go deeper. You know, the shadow things, when you receive the shadow things, you don't get tired. People want to receive those things without getting tired. But when you receive those things that are digged, digged out in the depth, you must get tired. Because you will knock the ground, you will dig until you dig. You will dig days, months. Then, that's when you receive. And the time you receive, you say, oh, I have worked it out for this thing. I have worked it out for these things. I have gone deeper. I have digged out. You see, you will have to struggle to dig that thing. But that will be precious. That will be worth. That will be the best one. The good one. The original one. Because it is from the depth. Hallelujah. So the things that you may be looking, the things that where you may be going, the mercy that you may be going, you cannot receive it. In that shallow level, you must go deeper with the Lord Jesus. Go deeper. Go deeper. Let your root sink deep into holiness. Let your root sink deep into obedience, into faithfulness, into righteousness. Let your root go deeper into fearing God. Don't just, there are people who are just operating in that shallow level. You don't sin because you fear people. You don't sin when you are in the presence of people because I am with the brethren. So I cannot sin here. Go deeper in that fear of God. And go deeper that you cannot sin because God is watching you. You are present. God is with you. Go deeper. There are people that are still living in sin because they are in the shallow places. Shallow level. You are still struggling with sin. You are still struggling with some of the things. No, you need to operate in the depth. Into the depth. Stop struggling with those kind of sin. You need to go at the depth and to destroy them, to uproot them. Yes, and now you shall experience the presence of the Almighty God. Hallelujah. There are things that you shall never receive. But for you, for those that will go at the depth, they that will launch out into the depth, they will receive something from God. And that is in the Word of God. I will reveal it unto you right now. I will reveal it unto you right now. I have been wondering. I have been asking a lot of questions. But God answered me. And those are the things that God have preserved for us. For those that seek the Lord. Those that hunger and seek the Lord. Those that go deeper. Those that launch out into the depth. Those that want to dig to the depth. Those are they that God is speaking to them. There are things that God will reveal to you. Let us read here in the book of Isaiah. There are treasures that you will receive. Yes, there are treasures that you shall receive them. Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45, 3. Isaiah 45, 3. We are finishing. The Bible says this. I am reading. This is what the word of God said. And I will give thee the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches. Hallelujah. You need to underline that. I will give thee the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of the sacred places, that thou may know that I, the Lord, which call you by your name, am God of Israel. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus Christ. Glory to the Lord Jesus. Glory to the Lord, Lord God of Israel. This is what God is saying. This is a good news to you who want to seek God. You who want to launch out into the deep. You who you are not comfortable to that level. You want to know God more. You are crying for the revival. You are crying to know God more. You are crying. You want to go deeper. You want to go deeper. You want to go beyond that level of outward holiness. That level of just going to church. That level of just tithing. That level of just praying. You want to go deeper. You want to go deeper. When you go deeper, this is what God is saying to you, that you shall receive these things. When you go deeper, hallelujah, and I will give thee the treasures of darkness. There are treasures that you will be given, the treasures of darkness. You see, those treasures are treasures that are gold beyond. We know when you go at the depth, there is no even light. At the depth, people enter with the torches. Torches, because at the depth, there's no light, because the light cannot even penetrate there. So he say, and I will give you the treasures of darkness, those treasures that are hidden under those darkness, God will give to you. And the hidden riches of the sacred places, hallelujah, the hidden riches of the sacred places, God will give to you. And so he say, that thou may you know that I, the Lord, which call you by your name, am the God of Israel, hallelujah. And you shall know that he is God who called you the God of Israel, that when you seek God, God will give you the treasures, those treasures, yes, the riches. God will give you the hidden riches. He will give you the treasures of darkness. He will give you those things that are hidden in the sacred places. Hallelujah. That you may know he is God who deserves to be glorified. He is God who called you. He is God who have called you by your name. Praise Jesus Christ the Messiah. This is the time for the church of Jesus to go deeper so that they may understand the will of God, so that they may walk with the presence of the Holy Spirit. You know, there are things that God cannot reveal us. There are things that the Holy Spirit cannot reveal us if we don't go to the depth. Jesus Christ is waiting us into the depth. He is waiting us into the depth. Look at this. Even when that Peter, when he was called by Jesus, when he saw Jesus Christ there in the water, walking in the water, Jesus was not here at the surface of the water. He was there in the depth. He was there at the center, there in the water. And he was told, come, come, if you see me, come, if you believe, come and walk on the water. Jesus Christ is standing at the depth of the water. He's standing there at the depth of the water. And he's telling you, you must come. You must come. Unless you come in that depth, in that level that he's standing, you cannot communicate with him. You cannot be revealed certain things. There are things you cannot see. There are riches that you will never see. There are hidden riches that you never see. There are sacred places that you will never go. You see, there are those treasures that you will never receive them. Because of your level. Hallelujah. From today on, begin to pray. Begin to launch out into the depth. Begin to grow. Begin to go deeper. Make sure that you are going deeper. That you are growing. Hallelujah. So that you may receive the understanding and the treasures that God has preserved for those that who love him. Hallelujah. And after seeking those things, you will be prepared. You will become perfect, and you shall know the goodness of the Lord, and you shall be raptured.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray in Jesus' name. Mighty Father, we come before you. We honor your holy name. We praise you, for there is none like you in heaven and earth. Thank you, Jesus, for the word of God that you have given to us. Thank you, Jesus, for giving us and giving us the word of God that we may launch out into the depth. And when we launch out into the depth, we shall now catch those fish. We shall now receive our treasures. We shall now receive our blessing and those secret riches that you have told us, the hidden riches of your kingdom. Mighty God, I pray in Jesus' name, give your people the grace to continue going deeper, to continue going beyond their levels, to continue loving you, to continue obeying you, to continue going beyond that level of holiness, going that level of order, going that level of prayers. Lord, I pray that help them by your grace that they may grow, that they may go to the root in the name of Jesus. Help your people, establish your people with the grace of God, with the glory of God, with the power of God in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Father, as you have spoken, that those who go deeper, Father, they receive from you. Those who dig out in the depth, they receive your treasures, they receive your riches, they receive your gift, they receive your glory and your power. I pray, Father, that those that will commit themselves to seek you in the depth, to know you in the depth of your depth and your height, Lord, I pray that you may reveal yourself to them. I pray that, Lord, they may receive what they are looking for. You may receive, you may answer their prayers in the mighty name of Jesus for your own glory. Mighty Father, I want to glorify your name, to praise you for such a word, Father, and for this word that you have revealed unto us. All the glory be given to you in the name of Jesus. I pray, Father, and whoever listen to this, Father, let them, Father, sink into their deep, Lord, that they may practice, that they may practice, that they may have to have the power, the grace, and the fruits in Jesus' name. Mighty God, I pray for your people that you shall remember them even in the kingdom of God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that whatever you are doing for they that seek upon you, receive them, the secrets of the kingdom of God. Reveal them, the secret of the kingdom of God. Reveal them, the deep things and the mysteries of your kingdom, in the mighty name of Jesus. For they are people who hunger and thirst to seek upon you, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We glorify your name. Thank you, Father, because of that word. Thank you, Father, because of those revival. Thank you, Father, because of your word. We glorify your name. We praise you, Jehovah, and we pray that all the glory, all the honor be given unto you. In Jesus' name, we do pray and even believe. Amen, amen, amen.
Install the Apostle Simon Gishinga application on Play Store for the End Time Epistles, writings of the last days with apostolic wisdom and revelation of the Word of God that prepares the Bride of Christ for the marriage feast of the Lamb of God. Beyond, the Kingdom of God is near and Jesus Christ is coming soon. Install from Play Store and read the Epistles. It's offline once you download.